Okay, before we get started, I just want to point out under File Administration, we have a series of new permissions for both Office and Go. So within the Production Control tab here, you can see the standard four tick boxes for work packages. That's within PowerFab Office. And then equally in Remote Permissions, we have a dedicated Work Packages tab there to determine what a particular user can and can't see and do within PowerFab Go. So just something to bear in mind as you start to use this new functionality. So I'm going to start by creating a few work packages. Now there are several ways of doing this, but most involve coming into the production control job and then going into the work packages option from the menu. You'll see here that I've already got a couple of work packages for this job already. So I'm going to click new to create a new one, and I'm going to create work package 3, which is some mixed structural steel. Okay, I need to choose a workshop, so in this case I will choose my main shop, and then I can choose optionally a start date and a due date. So I'll say starts on the 19th and it will be due on the 23rd. The groups 1 and 2 are optional but can be used again to further specify what it is or where it's going to be fabricated. So in this case I'll use group 2 to specify the work area within my workshop, and then again priority as low, medium or high to determine how they rank against similar work packages. Notes can be added for any additional information, and then if I click save, you'll notice I can now access the add assemblies button. So within here I can use my filters, and in this case I'm going to take out any trusses. Okay, and then I can equally use my navigation tree on the left hand side. So anything that's in lot 3 that's not a truss, I'm going to move over, and you can see that I'm assigning that to work package 3. So click assign to work package, and yep, and that will add those items to the work package, and we can now see we have a total of 30 assemblies with a weight just under 11 tons. Having added the assemblies, we can see them on the assemblies tab and the relevant properties like the paint finish and the weight, etc. I can also add and remove the assemblies from the options there. The parts will show me a list of all the parts by assembly, whereas the part summary will show, as the name suggests, a summarized list of parts where it will just kind of group together any parts that occur over multiple assemblies. There will just be a single row with a total quantity, and the warnings we'll come on to in a moment. On both the parts summary, parts and assemblies tab, you'll see an export button. This can be used to export drawings on the assemblies tab, and both drawings and CNC files on the parts and parts summaries tab. So just to an easy way of accessing the fabrication outputs there. Okay, so that's one way to create a work package. I'm going to come and create a new one, and this time I'm going to create work package 4, and this is going to be some trusses. Again, I'll choose my workshop. This time I'm going to choose my miscellaneous shop, and I'll say that's going to start on the 22nd through to the 25th, let's say. And once again, I can put some information here. Now I'm going to put a note of 5 times low profile trusses. So rather than using the add materials like I've just done, instead we can use the Trimble Connect model to select the assemblies we want. So I'll just pull that over now, and you can see it's already been colored by work package. So I can just come in here and select these 5 trusses, and back into PowerFab, right click and select from model. And there we can see those 5 trusses in there, assign those to the work package. And once again, they've now been added. Now there's a couple of additional buttons over on the right hand side under the status area. So the links will display any material dependencies, so whether it's been ordered, whether it's been delivered, whether it's on a cut list, etc. And you've got access to all of that information down on the buttons from the bottom. The cut lists will show you any cut lists that are associated to the parts on the work package. Drawings will open the drawing log, again, filtered for any assembly or part drawings relevant to the work package. And then we'll look at the production status and load tracking once we've actually gone ahead and done some tracking. So the third way I want to show you of creating work packages is using the Smart Create. So this can be used if you regularly use a standard set of properties in order to derive your work packages. I'm just going to set my filters again. I just want to remove the cold rolled items from here. Okay, so by choosing one or more value in these options here, so I'm going to choose lot, and then as an example, I'm going to choose category. I must choose a workshop as well. So what this will do, it will look at all the kind of the unique combinations of the two values in this case, so lot plus category, and create an individual work package for each of those. So I can see I've got lot 5 columns, lot 5 trusses, lot 6 beams, lot 6 columns, etc, etc. If I change that to finish for argument's sake, you'll see there's fewer work packages, but again, it's the same. It is making the unique combinations of lot plus finish. In this scenario, I'm just going to just create them by lot, and I can come through here and just put the work package prefix on here just to match the others I've done. Hit create, and that will go ahead and create those work packages. And there they are. So typically at this point, I'd go through and add the start date, due date, and any other relevant information to those new work packages. For the sake of time, I won't do that now. The other way that you can create work packages is from importing them from the modeling software, such as Tekla Structures. So if it is something you are already defining within the model, if you add that to part of the export, then you can map those on the way in, and then during the import process, those work packages will be created automatically. A couple of things I want to show you whilst I'm here. I'm going to open up work package number 5, and you'll see there's a banner at the bottom telling me that there are warnings on this work package. Now, what warnings do is they try to just alert you to any potential risks of the work package. Now, in this case, it's telling me that one of the cut lists associated is assigned to a different workshop than the work package itself, which in this case may be absolutely fine. You can double click on any of these warnings and go and investigate further or place put corrective action in place. Now, other warnings that you will see include when the dates of the work package conflict with the dates of the cut lists, or equally dates of the any planned loads that you've created. And you will also see warnings if any of the drawings associated with the work package are on hold. So back to the details tab. Now I want to just mention how you can use this if a work package is going to be subfabricated. So we can start by updating the workshop to reflect a subfabrication or a subcontract location. We can specify our start and due dates if we want in here. And I'll just type subcontract in my group 2. So that's one thing we can do, but also we can add the contents of the work package to a purchase order as subcontract items. So here I've already got a purchase order lined up, and this is very similar to when you're adding items to a subcontract purchase order from a load. It allows us to choose a single summary line, or we can add one line per assembly, or even one line per part, depending on the type of subcontracting that's going on. In this case, I'll just create one line for each assembly, and that will add those to the purchase order. So now I can apply pricing and send that off to my subcontractor to keep a record of that transaction. Okay. So up until this point, we've only looked at the work packages for a single job, but it is also possible to view that same screen for all jobs. So if I come up to maintenance, production control, and work packages from here, and I'll just move all jobs over for now. This is going to show me the same screen, but now it's going to include all jobs. You can see there's a toggle up here to include or exclude completed work packages. So typically you'd probably want to exclude the completed ones, but now you're starting to see kind of all of those work packages, and using the start date and due date, we can see how they kind of are ranked against one another. Over on the right hand side here, we have a column called release to fab, and that showed me the date that these work packages were released to fabrication. So we can take the work package that we created a few moments ago, and you've just got the buttons down here for release to fab. You can also do it from within the work package itself. So when you're at a point where you want to send that into the workshop, you can set the release to fab, and you'll see that will add the date on there. Equally, we have the ability to place work packages on hold. So I can come to work package 2. Now I can see in here that if I come to my warnings tab, that I have a couple of drawings that are currently on hold. So I might want to place that work package on hold. I can see it's already been released, but I could say awaiting drawing approval or something like that. And okay that. And that will place that work package on hold. The notes are there for everyone to see, and then that will flag as being read on there. Another way in which I can view all of the work packages across all jobs is via the prioritize button here, which will load up the embedded PowerFab Go interface. Here I've got my filters, so I'll come back and have a look at those in a moment, but here I'm seeing the same information just in the web application. This is the same as what the shop floor will see, more or less. So I can see all of the same information. I've got my settings up here to choose which columns I do and don't want to see. And again, if I prefer to use this interface to manage the work packages, I have all the same tools. So I can come in here and select to either unrelease or release, depending on what the current status is. Equally, I can put it on hold. And all of these are dependent on your permissions, but I can also come here and edit any work package properties as I need to. As I say, we've got some filters up here, so I might want to say, well, only show me the work packages that are currently scheduled to a subcontractor, for argument's sake. And if I come into here now, I'm just going to go and see those three work packages, and again, I might choose to then release those if they are ready to be sent to the subcontractor. We'll see more of this in the next stage where we look at the shop floor tracking. We also have a series of new reports that are dedicated to work packages. Now, I won't go into detail on all of these, but one that's particularly nice is the work packages due this week by location. So I can see for each of my three workshops there, what's due in the next 7 days. That's nice. And then you can see the other reports that we've also got available. I'm going to quickly jump back into the production control job just to show you some of the filters we have available around work packages. So you can see on the navigation tree here, we've added the work package number, so you could filter for a specific work package there. And if we come up to our production control filters, you can see that not only do we have the ability to filter by the work package itself, but also a bunch of additional properties such as start date, due date, priority, the workshop, whether it's on hold or not. So again, you can filter down to the information you are looking for. We also have the same set of filters in the model interface. So I'll start by colorizing the model just by the work package number. Okay, so there we can see the work package, all the different work packages broken down in the model. And then if I use my filters, I can say, well, I also want to see only the work packages that are due by the end of the week, let's say. So if I apply that and reopen the model, it's going to give me the same view, just filtered for, in this case, the due date.